Hello everyone. Today we will learn how to set up Laravel Sail on WSL 2. Let's take a look at the first step to enable WSL 2. First, we need to open Windows PowerShell in Run as Administrator mode, then copy and paste the command in PowerShell. Okay, it's open. Let's copy and paste it into PowerShell. Let's move on to the next step. As you can see, in order to use WSL 2, your system must meet the requirements. Next, copy the command and paste it into PowerShell. Let's move on to the next step. Then we download the installer to update WSL. Once the download is complete, run the installer. I have already run it. If you haven't, then run the installer and click Next as usual. Let's move on to the next step. Copy and paste the command into PowerShell again. Okay, let's continue. Now we need to download a Linux distribution to install on WSL. I will be using Ubuntu version 22. I have already downloaded Ubuntu. If you haven't downloaded it yet, please download it first. Run the installer that you just downloaded, then a terminal will open. This terminal will ask us to enter a Ubuntu user account. Open the terminal that appeared after running the installer. Then we will enter the username for the Ubuntu account. After that, enter the password for the Ubuntu account. Also, re-enter it to confirm the password. Okay, it seems that the installation of Ubuntu is complete. Now, type the command that I entered in your terminal, then press Enter. Enter the password for the account that you just created. Then wait until the update process is complete. Once it's done, we'll move on to the next step. To run Laravel Sail, we obviously need Docker. Please download and install Docker if you haven't already. Let's open Docker Desktop. Then open Settings. In the General tab, make sure that Use the WSL2 based engine is checked. Then, in the Resources tab, go to the WSL Integration tab and enable your Linux distribution. After that, please click the Apply and Restart button. Then you can quit Docker Desktop and reopen it or restart it. Then make sure that the Linux distribution is active. After that, Laravel Sail can be used. Now we will try to create a test project with Laravel Build. Open your Ubuntu terminal, then copy and paste the command into the terminal. Don't forget to run Docker. Then wait until the download process is complete. After the process is complete, run the test project by copying the following command. It seems that the project is running normally. Let's check Docker Desktop to see the containers that have been built with Laravel Sail. You can see the running containers in Docker. Now let's try to open the website at localhost. It seems that we need to migrate the database first. Stop the container by pressing Ctrl-C. Remember that to run the database migration, we use Laravel Sail, not PHP like usual. Let's check the environment variables using Nano. You can see the environment variables here. To exit Nano, press Ctrl X. Next, we will migrate the database using Laravel Sail. First, run Laravel Sail in detached mode. Then run the database migration command with Laravel Sail. Don't forget that when using Laravel Sail, you need to use the vendor. Okay, done. Now try refreshing the website. Success! The website is running normally. Now you can stop the container. Okay, that's the tutorial for a Laravel Sail project with Laravel Build. Now, to install Laravel Sail for an existing project that wants to use Laravel Sail, let's open your Ubuntu terminal. Then copy and paste the following command into the terminal. Then enter your Ubuntu user's password. Then copy the next command and paste it into the terminal. Done. Now proceed to the next step. Copy and paste the command again in the terminal. Just type Y. Wait until it's finished. Next, copy and paste the command again to install Composer on Ubuntu. Copy and paste the command again. Next, copy and paste the command again. Then copy and paste the command again. Make sure the output is installation verified. You can see installation verified. Let's move on to the next step. Copy and paste it into the terminal. Okay, done. Let's move on to the next step. Let's check if Composer is installed by copying the following command into the terminal. We have finished installing Composer. Next, prepare your project in Ubuntu WSL. I have a project repository that I will use as an example on GitHub. I am copying the repository link to clone it with Git. Use your project repository link to clone. I will enter my GitHub username and personal access token. Use yours. After cloning the repository, change the Active Directory of the terminal to the project. Then copy and paste the command into the terminal. It seems I need to install the PHP extension in Ubuntu. We can see that from the error message. If you encounter a similar issue, you can install the required PHP extensions by checking the error message. Here, I need to install the DOM extension. Yours may be different. Type your Ubuntu account password. Then wait for the process to complete. After that, let's try installing Laravel Sail again. Wait for the process to complete. Next, we need to create the environment variable file. Adjust its content according to your project. Next, copy and paste the command into the terminal. In this project, I will use PostgreSQL as the database and MailPit as SMTP. Use the spacebar to select or deselect. Use the up and down arrows to navigate and press enter to finish. Wait for the process to complete. Also, make sure Docker Desktop is running. Next, we need to run the container. I will run it in detached mode. Then, we need to run the database migration. Then, we need to generate the app key. For this part, I will install the dependencies using PNPM. If your project does not use Node.js, you can skip this step. Then I will build with PNPM. You can also skip this if your project does not use it. Done. Let's check the website on localhost in the browser. The website looks great. Next, we need to publish with Laravel Sail. Scroll down to see how to publish with Laravel Sail. Remember that to use Laravel Sail, we need the vendor folder. Okay, it has been published. Now we just need to remove the unused Docker folders from our project. Open your Ubuntu WSL using the File Explorer. Then go to your home user directory. There you will find the cloned project folder. Inside, there is a folder named Docker. You can delete the ones you do not need. Here I am removing PHP 8.1 and 8.2, as well as MySQL. Okay, we have completed the setup of Laravel Sail for the existing project. See you next time.